So hi everybody, I'm Ramesh Aravi, and obviously there is a lot of buzz about data science. Whether you call it knowledge management, whether you call it analytics, whether you call it whatever, right now it seems to be a skill which almost every manager, every technical person, everyone needs it. In fact, I just came, just before coming to this program, I was watching a news item on Times Now or News Now, one of those channels, where, I mean, it looks like NASCOM, I mean, a lot of these existing IT companies are letting go of their existing skills, okay, and making way for new skills. And one of the primary new skills that everyone is looking for is in the area of data science, artificial intelligence, machine learning, etc., etc., right? So today's session, I want to, you know, briefly give you an introduction to my understanding of this whole field. I mean, they're all very closely related to each other, right? So my attempt today will be to try and condense the essential concepts that underlie all these data science, or you may call it machine learning, or you may call it artificial intelligence, whatever, right? Essentially, I am not really a techie. In fact, I've had about 30 years of work experience as a manager in IT companies, but I've always been in a business role, you know, either managing sales or managing projects and stuff like that, right? And one of the things that I realize that as managers, the most important skill is to manage using data. Like Swapnil introduced, you know, the best companies, Infosys for example, I mean, I consider Narayan Murthy my guru. I mean, and the reason why Narayan Murthy was able to set up a company like Infosys from scratch into clearly a world-class company is his ethos on managing analytically, managing with data. I mean, I know for a fact that no person could go to Narayan Murthy just like that saying, sir, mujhe ye karna hai. No. Data pata. In God we trust, all others, please bring data and then only we talk. Okay. So, I'm deeply, you know, impressed. And so for the last 7 years, I mean, I finished my education about 37 years ago. So for 7 years, I've now been associated with teaching mainly in management institutes and so on and so forth, and modeling and analytics and using analytics for management is really my current passion, right? And that is what I wanted to introduce to all of you. You know, underlying all this funda talk, I believe that there are essentially 9 techniques which serve the basis. Dekhiye, aisa hai ki whenever you learn any new knowledge, any new body, any new subject, right? Every subject has a foundational logic. And on that foundation is further more complex concepts, etc., that are built, right? So my understanding is that if we understand the 9 concepts that I'm going to talk to you about today, all of you will have a much better understanding of this thing called data science or machine learning or artificial intelligence. Of course, I mean, it's a very, very vast field and it's growing really rapidly, which means there is solid scope for people who enter this field right now. Because agle 30-40 saal, another 30-40 years, this looks like where all industries are headed towards, right? So I think this is a good starting point, I mean, to discuss these 9 foundational techniques. But I must warn you, I mean, it is a new subject and hence there will be some level of difficulty, okay? Although I will try to make it as simple and as easy to understand, and fortunately, since I have not been a techie myself, I don't understand technology too well. Matlab, main ye jargon mujhe time lagta hai to understand, okay? But at the same time, the concepts are not straight away. I mean, they're not intuitive. Aisa bachchon ka khel nahi hai. These are something that you need to, you know, sort of get into. And in fact, a lot of these foundations are built on statistics and mathematics and so on and so forth. In fact, those who were good in maths will find these subjects very easy, okay? But those who are not may find it a little heavy, right? So, but with that warning, I don't want to discourage anybody, okay? Because it is interesting and I will try to make it as user-friendly as possible, yeah? So let's get into these 9 techniques, okay? Technique number one, oh, okay, before that, I mean, very briefly, let me talk about what is data science. I mean, data science is the extraction of interesting knowledge from data. Okay, so you have data, I mean, you have all kinds of data. I mean, you have transactions, you have invoice data, you have GST will now generate a whole ton of data, you know. IT returns will generate a whole ton of data. There is data, data, data all over, right? So the ability to extract knowledge from data, which is non-trivial, matlab aisa nahi ye faltu nahi, matlab it is really something wazandar, okay? Implicit, matlab it must be in the data. Aap apna masala bahar ka masala nahi laga sakte is pe. डेटा में दिखना चाहिए, मतलब आप अपना स्टोरी लेके मत आओ, ओके? इट मस्ट बी प्रीवियसली अननोन, मतलब वी डिडंट नो अबाउट इट, ओके? एंड इट मस्ट बी पोटेंशियली यूजफुल, आई मीन विल इट इंक्रीज माय प्रॉफिट्स, विल इट रिड्यूस माय कॉस्ट, विल इट हेल्प मी फाइंड न्यू कस्टमर्स एक्सेट्रा, राइट? सो विद दोस एसेंशियल प्रिंसिपल्स, let's start with the first, you know, technique. And this technique is a technique called classification. Okay. So what is classification? I mean, pardon me, but I will use, you know, very kya bolta hai, official type of language. Okay. Because it is, it must be. I mean, it must be rigorous. It's not a movie. I mean, it's serious stuff. Okay, right? So, classification and class probability estimation. A probability, by the way, as I said, statistics is a very important concept in this, and you will hear probability again and again and again. Right? Is an attempt to predict for each individual in a population which of a small set of classes this individual belongs to. Correct? Makes sense? That's classification, right? So with an example, I'm sure, you know, things will become very clear. An example question in classification would be, among all the customers of a telecom company, which, I think some people are not able to sorry for the interruption. Is this presentation audible to you? There are few people who are facing problem on the audio side. I think you should turn on the speaker. Yeah, we will go ahead.
Sorry, sir. Lecture good for IIT Bombay professor.
Okay, so we took an example of a classification. It would be a telecom company, okay? Airtel wants to launch a new, you know, package to its existing customers. Let's say Airtel has just tied up with Amazon Video and said, "Yeah, you know, you buy this 4G pack of ours with, you know, 25 GB download every month for 2,000 rupees extra, and you will get, you know, two Amazon Video movies bundled in every month." Okay, that bundle is there, right? Now they want to test which amongst our existing customers will respond to this offer. Say, okay, I will sign up, I'll pay this 2,000 rupees, or will not respond, right? So this is a typical classification problem, a problem where from your existing set of customers, you want to know ki, okay, you will probably buy the Amazon Video, and Mr. Ramesh Adavi, who, you know, is scared to touch a computer, will say, nahi yaar, ye video, hum picture dekhenge, to I will see it only in the movie theater, I'm not interested in this, right? So, you run an algorithm. Typically, I mean, you run a logistic regression algorithm for a two-class problem. This is a two-class problem, okay? Respond, not respond. And you will predict so-and-so person, age so-and-so, student so-and-so, past mobile usage so-and-so, versus Ramesh Adavi, age so-and-so, past mobile usage, no data, I mean, not a single case of data usage, only use, etc., etc. You know, for example, that Ramesh Adavi will not respond, and you will respond. Your name, please? Rajeshwari will respond, right? So, that is a classification problem. Now, there is obviously a lot of value to this, right? So telecom companies will do a logistic regression quite often, right? Now closely related to this task of, you know, classifying whether X will respond, not respond, or belong to a class, okay? There is a related thing of probability of responding, okay? So the probability of, for example, and this probability or probability estimation funda is used very often in credit risk analysis. Matlab when banks want to give loans, okay, should I give loan to this person, not give loan to this person, or I want to issue a credit card, right? Can or not issue a credit card? There, the algorithm will tell you the probability of default of Ramesh Adavi will be very low. You know, the who, you know, track record is very low, etc. Whereas someone new, Rajeshwari, for example, who's never had a credit card record, and we know from past data that, right? The probability of default for Rajeshwari is high, probability 0.9, right? So you can also have scoring. And this is what is done. I mean, CIBIL score, you get these mails, right? Get your CIBIL score at 750 and so on and so forth, right? They do this kind of classification or probability estimation, class probability estimation, right? I hope it's making sense. So classification and scoring are closely related, and a model that can do one usually can do the other. Wo to hai hai, right? But the main point I want to drive is the concept of classification, right? So that's the other guys, everyone, can you hear me? Okay, they're muted up. Okay. Next is the concept of regression. Okay. Regression value estimation attempts to estimate for each individual a numerical value of some variable for that individual. Numerical value. So here now, we're talking about whether he belongs to, you know, a default class or non-default class. Here we are talking of, you know, how much sales will increase. Okay, we'll take an example. Okay, how much will a given customer use the service? Like I have, you know, launched this new Amazon package and 25 GB from my telephone company. How much, I mean, will he download 25 GB, will he download 30 GB, will he pay me 2000, or will this customer pay me, will, you know, monthly billing rate I can have up to 4000. Now we are talking of numbers, numerical values. So when we are trying to find out about the numerical value, we use techniques called regression. Yeah. Fine, this makes sense? Alright. So, regression and classification, I mean, all these techniques, as I said, they're all related. I mean, all of them, you know, have a fundamental logic. If you go deep inside, I mean, they're all very similar to each other, except that they address different kinds of variables. In the first case, we are addressing a class. Okay. In the second, now we are trying to address a value. We are trying to predict how much, right? So they are closely related, whereas one will predict whether something will happen. The other will predict how much that will happen. Okay. The third is something called similarity matching. Okay, very important. Similarity matching attempts to identify similar individuals based on data known about them. Similarity matching can be used directly to find similar entities. Okay. Now, why would we want to find similar entities? We'll know very soon. I mean, why it's important, right? For example, IBM. Someone said from IBM, right? You're from IBM?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So IBM is interested in finding companies similar to their best business customers, like, you know, for network support. Okay. I mean, say you are the head of the network support division and boss ne bola hai, please go and get some business, right? So how would you do it? You would look at customers who have bought network support from IBM. And they are buying quite a bit. Okay, so Airtel is a great IBM customer, right? Huh? Yeah, I agree. I mean, so I know Airtel was initially IBM's biggest, I think, you know, when it started, right? Okay, so Airtel is a big customer, right? So now I take Airtel and I find out which are the other customers that are similar to Airtel. And you say, ah, Vodafone, telecom company, requires the same kind of services that, you know, Airtel has, etc., etc., right? So I look for similarities with Airtel. Similarities in, I mean, now what are those similarities? They'll be in terms of industry, okay, telecom, size, number of employees, technology that they use. They also use, you know, system 36, and they also have some legacy COBOL programs to, you know, translate, and they also, you know, want to implement this analytics for telecom, that, you know, etc., etc. Okay. So this is how similarity helps, right? Finding out similar customers, right? And you do similarity matching so that you can segment your market. Clear? So it's the basis for making product recommendations. We'll see. And there are techniques for similarity, like, I mean, technically, it's important for us to recognize that similarity matching is an important data science technique. Okay, how we do it, etc., you know, you use Euclidean distance and you use cosine similarity, all that. You need to, you know, get into, I mean, obviously you will have to get into it if you really want to use data science, if you want to get into this field, right? But right now, let's just understand the basic fundamentals. Okay. The fourth is clustering, right? So we, I mean, the word itself says it, right? It is similar. Individuals are naturally clustered together. Okay. And this is a form of learning which is called unsupervised learning. I mean, we won't get into what is supervised, unsupervised. It will take a lot of time, but I mean, yes. So why would you do clustering? Yes. Okay. Clustering, I mean, most data science projects usually start with what is known as exploratory data analysis. You know, you just, I mean, you have all this data about your customers. So you first, I mean, maybe draw a few plots here and there, etc. But one of the important starting points of most data analyst projects is with clustering. Matlab, you find out amongst your customers, is there some natural grouping? Matlab, right? So you use clustering techniques. And then when you find that, okay, students, usage, senior citizen, their usage, their billing patterns, their, you know, kinds of services that they use, you find that your customer base gets naturally segmented by using a clustering technique. And then for separate clusters, you have separate marketing strategy, and that's called micro-targeting. Okay, ki students ke liye students pack, senior citizens ke liye senior citizens pack, okay, which might include ki ghar pe aake check collect karenge. Of course, for that we will charge 20 rupees additionally per month. But when, you know, all that 20 rupees for, you know, 100,000 senior citizens are all combined together in a particular location, that itself might become a service. You get it, right? It serves the senior citizen and it becomes a new business line for you, right? So that's something called micro-targeting. And in fact, marketing, this is a very common technique, you know, segmenting. And for different segments, different, you know, offers, different products, different services, different approaches. Yes. Fine. So clustering is used as an input for decision-making processes based on questions such as, what product should I offer senior citizens? What product should I offer students? How should our customer care teams or sales teams be structured? You know, get it? Right. So that's, am I making sense?
Yes.
Okay. So let's go on to topic number 5. Co-occurrence grouping.
Yeah.
Okay. Co-occurrence grouping, and by the way, this originally, this whole concept of data science or data mining as it is called also, I mean, they're all related, as I said. Yeah.
Yeah, we are getting some requests from the most of the participants, that few of the participants like a Pradeep has not muted the mic. I request Pradeep and the other participant to mute their mic so that we can have a flawless session. I request Pradeep to mute the mic. I request Vishesh to please mute the mic. Mr. Vishesh, please mute your mic.
Muted. Unmuted.
This concept of data mining actually started with this co-occurrence grouping. Co-occurrence, matlab, okay, let's read that definition out there, okay? Co-occurrence grouping, also known as frequent item set mining, okay? Association rule discovery and market basket analysis. Ab ye bada lamba, it's becoming too complicated. But let's look at this market basket analysis. Typically, a web commerce company, Flipkart, or any of these companies, they have what is known as a shopping cart, correct? Okay. In what goes into the shopping cart is the market basket, right? So analyzing ki, you know, Ramesh Adabi's market basket every month includes, you know, Vim soap, this, that, etc., etc. Yours, I mean, what's your name?
Karandeep.
Huh? Oh, okay. Karandeep's includes maybe XYZ, right? And so on and so forth. So everyone, whenever he goes to the shopping, does shopping, generates a basket, right? So analyzing these baskets is what co-occurrence grouping is all about, right? So while clustering looks at similarity between objects based on their attributes, matlab, you know, age, yeah, whether student, not student, income, etc., etc., these are attributes. Co-occurrence grouping considers similarity of objects based on their appearing together in the transactions. Samajh gaya na? To market basket mein, which are the items that occur together very often? Which are the items that occur in Karandeep's basket? Which are the items that occur in Rajeshwari's basket? Okay, which are the items that occur most common just before, you know, it's about to start raining? Which are the items that occur most common in the month of April or in the month of June, where the school season is about to begin? Okay. So if you have this kind of information, won't you be able to do a much smarter job of stocking? Right? June mein umbrella, school bag, notebooks, etc. etc.
Milk and bread.
By the way, I mean, you raised a very important question. I mean, milk and bread to roj ka. It's not interesting. See, this is one of the
muted.
Every day.
Unmuted.
And you know approximately how much of it is required. You know that it will be required every day. Okay. So it's not interesting. I mean, that's one of the fundamental tenets of data science. I mean, right in the beginning, it should be new. It should be something previously unknown. Milk and bread ka mujhe malum hai. So sorry, maaf karna. We cannot accept that project, but we'll accept some other project. But this is a very important point you raised. You raised the question, but now you know that there's no use. I mean, milk and bread, to we all know. Okay, right. Anyway. Simply, correct? Here is something useful.
I mean, this is very good.
So while we're doing this you know, co-occurrence grouping or data mining or basket analysis, as they call it, there are three measures that are important. One is support. I mean, support is the measure of, you know, how many transactions out of all my transactions contain these items. I mean, unfortunately or fortunately, milk and bread will always be there. So milk and bread will always have very high support. That's what it means, right? But support is important. But I mean, I don't want to waste too much time. Kyunki kya hai, see, one of the problems that data science tries to solve is इतना सारा इंफॉर्मेशन आ रहा है और इस इंफॉर्मेशन से मतलब ये हमारे गिने चुने डायमंड्स कैसे, हाउ डू आई सिलेक्ट यू नो दोस फ्यू आइटम्स दैट विल रियली मैटर. आई मीन मिल्क एंड ब्रेड, यस, आई मीन एवरीवन बाइज इट रेगुलरली, इट्स वर्थ यू नो गोइंग आफ्टर इट एंड कीपिंग अ क्लोज वॉच ऑन इट, बट इट्स समथिंग दैट आई नो ऑलरेडी. आई मीन राइट, I need to find out something that I don't know, right? For that, I do what is known as association rule discovery and so on and so forth, okay? Right? So support is important. I mean, out of 1,000 transactions, I don't want to look at those items that were bought only once, only by one person, okay? Usme jyada interest nahi. 10, 20, okay, some number, okay? So support is important. Confidence is, you know, the confidence of an association between two items. Like say, for example, there is a strong association between me being an IT professional and buying a book on analytics. There is a strong association, right? So that is the confidence. I mean, every time I notice that so and so person is an IT professional, how many times did IT professionals buy the book on Lean Analytics? Okay, so that is a measure of confidence. So confidence, if I know the confidence, I mean, I know ki yaar, whenever I discover so and so, ki Mandeep, right? Karandeep, that Karandeep is an IT professional, I have a good chance of being able to promote Lean Analytics to you because it has high confidence. Okay, that association between IT professional and has a high confidence, right? Now, going one step further is the concept of lift. Okay, lift is the measure which increases the chances of a particular item being bought, okay, given that I already know of the fact that he's an IT professional and has bought a book on Lean Analytics from me. Okay, this is how recommendation engines work. I mean, if you pay close attention, you will notice that, okay, for example, you will notice that our programming, the book on our programming has been bought by, say, out of 1,000 transactions, 1,000 purchases, our programming book has been bought 6 times, right? So the probability you'd expect anyone to buy our programming book is 6/1,000. Okay, so that is what you would normally expect. Okay, someone to, any random person to buy, right? But when your data tells you that, when I know that the person is an IT professional and that he's bought a book on Lean Analytics, okay? Huh. 90% of such people have bought a book on our programming. So where is 90% and where is 0.6%? Huge difference. So this difference is what is known as the lift. Right? So association rule mining helps you identify which are the associations which have maximum lift, right? And how will you use this lift information? By building a recommendation engine. Okay, recommendation is, Mr. IT professional, you bought a book on Lean Analytics. All people who bought a book on Lean Analytics also bought a book on our programming. What are the chances that you will probably, see, because, so now you see how similarity and, you know, association rule mining and so on and so forth lifts the chances, and how you can do upselling. How you can, you know, target specific customers for specific. Now imagine Amazon does this online all the while every time. Matlab aap log, one of the reasons why Amazon is, you know, where it is valued at what it is aap Amazon mein char bar, if you do 4 or 5 transactions in Amazon, it will know so much about you that progressively more and more you will find that whenever I go on to Amazon, I will I will find something that I'm looking for. Google also does that, by the way. I mean, Google also, I mean, nowadays it's so smart that whenever I type something like in R programming, I mean, it gives me a whole list of other items. This is called topic modeling. I mean, in a way, it's very similar to, you know, this same association rule mining, right? Get it? Okay, so just, you know, just to explain this concept of, you know, how a recommendation engine works, okay? On the left-hand side, U1, U2, U5 are users, various, you know, customers, etc., etc. These are items, okay? Items can be books. In fact, Amazon, I mean, they first were in books, and books is a great, great, you know, product for recommendations. Because, you know, preferences and so on and so forth are inbuilt. I mean, an IT guy in analytics will buy a whole set of, you know, similar matching, you know, closely associated products, right? So, let's say these guys are, you know, IT type guys. User 1, user 2 are IT professionals. And item number one that they bought was, let's say, a book on lean analytics. Item number one. Item number two is, let's say, R programming. Item number three, lo and behold, is Vedantic philosophy. Just, you know, out of the blue. Let me, you know, ये सब ऐसे ही ये आईटी वाले कुछ हवा में विवेकानंद ये वो कुछ कुछ करते रहता है मतलब यू नो ओके सो दिस फॉर्म्स अ काइंड ऑफ अ क्लस्टर राइट नाउ यूजर नंबर टू ओके इज सिमिलर टू यूजर नंबर वन बिकॉज ऑफ the fact that they buy similar products, right? So they form a cluster. Is everyone, I mean, can you see that? Yeah. Now they form a cluster. Now here, user number one has bought this book on R programming, and user number two has logged in, and he says, hey, you know, those who bought this book on, you know, lean analytics and Vedantic philosophy, they also bought books in our programming. And we just saw that has great lift, right? Okay. I mean, there's a 90%. Now there is a 90% probability because the lift number shows that, right? There's a 90% probability that I will buy this. The original probability of an R programming book to be bought is 0.6%. But with the right recommendation and with the right knowledge of lift, okay, I increase that to 90%. This is done analytically. Now, isn't this useful?
Yes.
It is, right?
Yes.
Okay. Similarly, this group might be a group of housewives or, you know, okay. So this book might be a book on, you know, cookery, Tarla Dalal's book on cookery and Sanjeev Kapoor's book on how to make chicken 69 ways or something like that, okay. And this would be a book on, you know, how to raise children in their, or, you know, how to do homework with school children, right? Now, user number four, user number three, they're all housewives, they're similar. When she logs in, hey, Sanjeev Kapoor ka wo chicken ka kitab, why don't you look at it? And what are the chances? I live, right? So this is how a recommendation engine works, right? And there will be outliers. this also is important. I mean, who are they? Who are those people who, you know, don't fit in any cluster? They, okay. Is there something? I mean, this guy bought a book on space technology. Hai kya isme kuch? I mean, are there other people in our customer base who are like this?
Maybe.
Why not? Yeah, possibility is there, right? So that's it. That's so. How does an analytics, you know, thinker? I mean, yeah, he says maybe. Let's see. I mean, get the data, do one, you know, some create a table, and yeah, that's it, man. Yeah, get it. So that's the way to do it. Okay. So is it very late? Yeah, okay. So segmentation is clusters of similar items. Oops. Tell me if I'm going too slow, because now I think I will rush. It's not time ka problem. Okay, recommendation we saw.
Yes.
How recommendations are done. And items, I mean, yeah, okay. Yeah, so profiling. Swapnil, tell me when I should stop.
It's okay.
Yeah, I think we'll
continue. If audience is okay with it, then I don't have a problem.
Yeah, audience is okay with it?
Even the online audience.
Yeah. Hey, online audience, are you okay?
How do I know?
Right.
Yes.
Okay. Great. Thanks, guys. All right. So, profiling is... प्रोफाइलिंग मतलब देखिए ऐसा है कि सी देयर इज ऑलवेज अ वे ऑफ समराइजिंग समथिंग अबाउट अ पर्सन राइट एंड दैट्स व्हाट प्रोफाइलिंग इज ऑल अबाउट राइट एंड इट्स टू कैरेक्टराइज द टिपिकल बिहेवियर ऑफ एन इंडिविजुअल ग्रुप और अ पॉपुलेशन राइट ओके एंड वी समराइज दैट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू अब ये मैथमेटिक्स में आई मीन अ लॉट ऑफ यू वुड हैव हर्ड व्हाट एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू इज राइट एक्सपेक्टेड वैल्यू एंड डिविएशन और वेरिएशन आई मीन विद इन व्हाट लिमिट्स आई मीन कैन आई एक्सपेक्ट यू नो आई एक्सपेक्ट द एवरेज हाइट ऑफ अ इंडियन टू बी 5 feet 8 inches लेट्स से ओके एंड इट वेरीज बिटवीन से 5 feet एंड से 6 feet 5 inches, right? So that's how you typically profile the behavior of the height of average Indians, right? Similar, and in addition to, you know, a gross profile, there is also what is known as conditional profiling. I mean, conditional is when you're given additional information. I mean, additional information as to he's a student. Okay, so the profile of height of people who are students is different from the average profile of all Indians. Correct? Mm-hmm. Right. So that's conditional profiles. Okay. So profiles are best described by probability distributions. Okay, I don't want to get too much into detail about, you know, probability distributions and this and that and the other, but suffice to say that probability and probability distributions is an extremely important concept in data science. I mean, in fact, up to now, you must have noticed, you know, almost everything we talked about was, you know, probability of him buying, improving from 0.6 to 0.9, you know, probability of default, probability. Yeah. So probability is an extremely important part. So, I mean, if you want to get into it, you have to go back to your maths. Okay. Yeah. Not school. I mean, it's actually it goes far. I mean, it goes really deep, over and over again. But anyway, but probability is an important thing. Okay. And profiling is used for anomaly decision. You know, how do you find out कि ये normal behavior नहीं है यार? This looks like a fraud. Why? I mean, because normally Ramesh Adavi buys movie tickets only when he's in Pune. Right? Because he, I mean, Pune is his hometown and movies वगैरह Pune नहीं देखते यार. I mean, you don't go around, I mean, go to Delhi to watch movies, right? Okay. You might, I mean, once in a while, I mean, I go to Delhi touring and so on, but all that is part of my transaction history, by the way. Okay. So it might have been that I've gone on a sales call to Delhi and, you know, there was time on hand and maybe I did go for a movie and alone. Wo bhi matlab Delhi mein kaun hai, PV nahi hai, koi nahi hai. Okay. So alone. Okay. So that is acceptable. See. But in Delhi and, you know, 10 tickets all of a sudden, or, you know, I've never been to Chhattisgarh and, you know, suddenly a movie ticket, a very large number or something like that is not normal behavior, right? So profiling is continuously updated, your profiles are continuously updated to put an understanding of what normal behavior is and what is likely to be abnormal behavior. And that's how you do anomaly detection and so on and so forth. Fine? Let me skip all this because, I mean, it's yeah, I think I'll skip all this. I mean, when we go into details, it might be worth getting into all this. Okay. A seventh technique is linked prediction. Attempts to predict connections between data items, usually by suggesting that a link should exist between them. Two people, for example. Okay. And possibly estimating the strength of the link. Yeah. इन दोनों का होना चाहिए यार. LinkedIn will say यार, you must get connected to this guy. I mean, why? We will see the logic. Okay. Makes sense?
Yeah.
Yeah. Fine. Here, the variable is not the person. It's a link between two persons. That's the, you know, funda. Okay. So, and then you treat it like any other variable and, you know, manipulate variables. Find out probabilities and stuff like that. Correct? So that's link prediction. Data reduction. All of you have heard of this thing called the curse of dimensionality, right? Have you? Okay. Let me explain. In that, you know, table that we saw of, you know, Kukri books and, you know, item 1, item 2, item 3 and so on and so forth. Imagine that it is really about books, right? Now, there can be thousands of books, millions of books, right? So your item 1, item 2, item 3 is not just item 1, item 2 up to item 10. It is item millions, thousands. It's in millions, right? So when the table is so large, the chances that there will be any, you know, I'll just go back to that because this curse of dimensionality is a very important thing, right? A lot of our, you know, knowledge or decision making was based on the fact that, you know, I knew this, the green part, I knew about this part, but there is so much of white part where there is no knowledge and I can't do anything about it. I can't say anything, right? Now imagine that when there are millions of items like this, there will be a lot of white space.
White spaces, obviously.
Right? And if there is a lot of white space, it means that I don't have the knowledge, I can't do anything with it. And that is what is known as the curse of dimensionality. Very large dimension causes lots of white space and hence an inability to extract knowledge. Right? Okay. So, because there is this curse of dimensionality, I try to reduce these millions, these dimensions from millions to much shorter. Okay. So, I use data reduction techniques to do that. So, instead of a million, right, I reduce those millions of books into what are known as underlying factors or latent factors or principal components. Wo chodo. I mean, like say for example, in the Tarla Dala, in the books case, there might be, you know, all books on analytics, there might be 1,000 books on analytics, but they're all on analytics. So instead of looking at 1,000 titles, I condense that into a
analytics books,
okay, cooking books, child rearing books, right? And then, you know, I say, acha, this guy is interested in analytics instead of R programming and this, that, etc. This guy is interested in, so I reduce the dimensions. Right? Typically, I mean, even you know, the number of categories or genres or movies, etc., etc., also, you know, can be very large. Okay. So I try and reduce it to 2 because 2 helps me, you know, visualize better. I can use graphics better when I use 2. Okay. So, which are the most important topics which are of interest to all the people, and then from analytics to cookery to, you know, child rearing to 10 other different things, I come to, you know, most people are buying books on cookery and analytics, right? So I can keep reducing the number of dimensions.
Reducing.
Yeah, reducing so that I can manage, I can visualize, and I can, okay, I mean, it might be a little heavy, by the way, there are some, but this is an important concept, okay.
So we're talking about the, we will segregate the data on the basis of different categories.
Let me try and explain it a little more. You may get, but even if you get some funda, I mean, it's good enough. You know, for example, in a 1-1.5 hour session, it may not be possible to, you know, sort of go through it. But I can sense that there is some, you know, understanding, which itself is, I think, great. By the way, so that's. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So principal component analysis, chodo yaar, we'll talk about it a little later. Yeah, because it is a little deep. Yeah, so I don't want to, you know, overload. Kyunki it's generally not possible to. What are your movies, sir? I mean, I'll just give you example, and these are all, many of these are outputs of real, you know, real life type data sets. Okay. One of the great things about R is that this enormous amount of, I mean, libraries and data, and I mean, all this can be executed, and I mean, and I'm quite sure that, you know, if you go through an R programming skills in depth, I mean, with the data sets that are there in R, okay, you'll be able to just simply take someone else's data, plug that data in, and start churning out reports. I mean, it's that powerful, by the way. And we can do all that we've done here once you know all this, right? So, as I said, this is really some kind of a data of movies, and there are millions of movies and millions of users, right? Now, the tastes and preferences of millions of movies and millions of, no, thousands of movies and millions of users, that's the kind of ratio, okay, can be summarized that using some of the data compression techniques or data reduction techniques, okay, called principal component analysis, where all movies get separated out into natural categories. Okay. Dimension one is action and drama. You know, dimension one, starting with action and drama. Drama is melodrama, you know, meri maa, aise, aapke paas kya hai, mere paas gaadi hai, bangla hai. You know, that type. That's drama. Action is, you know, Mr. Shetty and, you know, okay. So, action, drama, and emotional, intellectual. You know, some people say, yeah, ye rona dhona mujhe achha nahi lagta. Man, thoda, you know, I want a plot, and, you know, usme ye hona chahiye, kuch hona chahiye, right? Okay, whatever it is, but it so happens that movies get categorized. Aisa nahi ki matlab we started off, we just took a whole lot of movies, put them in that table, and did a principal component analysis and came out with these two principal components only. Okay. And our movies got classified like this. तो अगला आदमी जब पिक्चर बनाने जाएगा, ही नो कि यार हाउ मेनी पीपल लाइक दिस टाइप ऑफ मूवीज, ये तो यार मसाला, मतलब पता नहीं क्या है ये, यू नो, टाइप ऑफ मूवी, इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू, यू नो, सॉर्ट ऑफ नो मूवीज, किसको अच्छा लगेगा, क्या लगेगा, बोल नहीं सकता, बट ये मुझे मालूम है, यू नो, people who like action, intellectual action, like, I don't know, I mean, you know better. Okay. So that's how it is. Rest is a bit technical, so let's skip it. And the last technique I'll talk about is something called causal modeling, which is very important, very difficult, and hence this is also going to be pretty heavy. Consider that you want to use predictive modeling to target advertisements, and we observe that given certain advertisements, there was an increase in sales. Okay, and this, by the way, is a very common problem. You know, advertising manager will say, boss, invest, yeah. I mean, and all of us know that it's extremely difficult to, you know, pinpoint that the increase of sales was due to advertisements. Was it really due to advertisements? Or was it that basically the product itself is good and people would have bought with or without advertisements. It's a very important question, by the way, okay, especially about advertisements, especially in marketing. Okay, so you use causal modeling techniques, and causal modeling techniques involve, you know, control groups and not control groups, trying to identify spurious, so you do randomized controlled experiments, so-called A-B tests, where in A, you know, the group has not been exposed to the advertisement. In B, the group has been exposed to advertisement. Now, it's not easy to conduct these kind of experiments, right? Assuming that everything else is equal and, you know, a group pe advertisement diya hai, dusre group ko advertisement nahi diya hai, or C, if, you know, group B buys more than group A, then only you can say, it's the advertisement, because everything else is equal. And keeping everything else equal is not always easy in life. But there are, again, statistical techniques, etc., etc., you know, which kind of isolate the effects of different fields and so on and so forth. But that's what causal modeling is all about. Yeah. I think I should stop here. And maybe, you know, sort of, yeah.
Yeah, so we have few, sir. Okay, I think dear participants, we have few queries and questions from